Good morning. This is Uncle Guy's Gospel Jukebox. Hopefully, prayerfully, we're going to play something that helps get you through the day. I know you're going to have rough moments because I have rough moments. But all I have to hear is that good traditional gospel music. Yeah, I'll throw in a little contemporary, but I gotta tell you, I'm a traditionalist. I love the old time gospel music, and I'm not talking about the gospel music that plays that woe is me song. Oh, he came and got my mother. And then he came and got my father. Okay, those songs help get us through. But you know what? It's a new day, new music, uplifting music. Let me give you a little taste. Let's start off with a little Kurt Carr. How's that?
God, once again.
Okay.
We come into your presence with expectancy in our hearts. God, we know you're going to bless us.
You got it.
Hands in the sanctuary, and we give you glory and honor.
Hi.
My name's JC McCauley.
I'm Naisha McCauley, and you're watching AccessTV.org.
If you feel like dancing, get up and dance. Okay. That's the purpose of this music. Help brighten your day. Brighten my day too.
We will praise you for the rest of our day.
Here on the Gospel Jukebox, from time to time, we're gonna have guest people, guest ministers, guest bishops, and let me say right now,
we will
Don't you feel better? Let's hear a little more Kurt Carr.
Words don't convey what's my heart.
this song says, God's mercy kept me.
Remember this?
So
I know you remember this. You got to have remembered this. Come on.
Just giving up. I'm not going to ask you to hunch anybody, but just look at them. That person you're looking at is here tonight only because of God's mercy.
I'm sending this song out to everybody.
Somebody ought to just tell God, thank you for your mercy.
Ever felt like this.
And your grace that kept.
You don't need to get pills. You don't need to drink. You don't need to shoot up. Listen to the words. How about you?
Tonight because of God's mercy. Come on now, just thank him. Just thank him.
Vicky, I know you know about this.
I almost let go. I felt like I just couldn't take life anymore. My
Okay.
But I long to
Kurt Carr and the Kurt Carr Singers. You know, Kurt Carr is from Hartford. Local boy who made good. Or should I say, local man who made good. Who made good. Come on, Uncle Guy, get it together. But anyway, hopefully, Kurt Carr and the Kurt Carr Singers brought a smile to your face. Made you think about the good times and the bad times. But you know what? We're going to keep rolling. Let's see who comes up next.
Let's go to the country, y'all.
Ah, Keith Wonderboy.
In a mean world like this, what we need the Lord to do is send a revival.
Send a revival.
Wonderboy Johnson used to come to Hartford with his father. You remember the gospel stars with Deacon Ledbetter?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Mean it from your heart.
All you gotta do is call his name.
Some dark days, but when I hear music like this, it brightens my day right up. How about you? Does it brighten your day? Brightens mine. Thank you, Keith Wonderboy. All the music you hear on this program is available on Amazon.com. Let's hear a little Charles Nix. He has transitioned, and he's no longer with us, but his good music is with us. Grandmother, she loved Reverend Charles Nix. Hopefully, as we get to know one another, I'll get a feel for what you like and what you don't like. Just know one thing, I'm a traditionalist. I can't emphasize enough. I'm a tradition. I love old time gospel singers, gospel choirs, gospel quartets, and most of all, good gospel preachers. How about you? What do you like? Huh? Let's listen.
Too far and high.
you haven't heard that in a long time, huh? Reverend Charles Nix. How about this, huh? Mother, mother used to sing this song.
To his word, I can only
You like that? I do. And that's what you're going to hear every week on the Gospel Jukebox. You know, like I said, if you don't like it, give me a shout out on my Facebook page. If you like it, do the same. We have a whole library of current, traditional, and old-fashioned gospel music and whatnot. And I want to hit the right mix that'll make you want to come back and listen. You know, I don't want to just play anything because it's gospel. It's got to be the right mix. It's got to say something to you like it says to me and whatnot. But I love it. How about you? Reverend Charles Nix. Thank you. Reverend Charles Hicks. Reverend Charles Nix. Amazon.com, that's where you find this music. Let us know what you think of the program. Did I get it right, or do I need to do better?
Yeah.
Uncle Guy, hopefully you've heard something that put a smile on your face. No matter what you may be going through, I'm not here to burden you down, put a lot of trip-trap trash in your ear. I want to put Jesus in your ear, okay? At this time, let me thank the people behind the scenes that make this possible. First of all, let me say thank you. A forgotten word in today's environment. Thank you to Reverend Stanley J. McCauley, great, great technical guy who makes this all possible. Let me say thank you to Bishop James Bishop, another backer of this program. Hopefully the next time we get together, he'll be here. And let me say thank you to you for listening. Without you, I'm nothing. The program is nothing. The program is nothing. So thank you for listening. And that's all I'm going to say. Let's get back to this good old gospel music. This is from the album 40 Great Gospel Hits. The album is out of Canada, but you can find it on Amazon.com.
Done all you know how to do. Tell God about it. getting ready to come to a close, but we just want to thank God, hallelujah, for the victory. For this is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous. Huh? Oh, bless him. Oh, I bless him.
Thank you and good night, good afternoon, good evening. Until next time, God bless. We'll be right back.
My name is Jay Stan McCauley, and I do business as Light Source Productions. I provide professional services in the area of strategic video communications. First, what we do is we help you craft your message using what I call the rule of the five W's: who, what, when, where, and why. We do event documentation, content acquisition, full-scale productions, editing, and of course, distribution through our social media television network. And with social media, video is more important now than it has ever been. Whether you're talking big business, small business, nonprofit, church, or just an individual. Let's say you're planning an event, a wedding, whatever the case may be, but let's say a big event, but no video. And you spent all this time, all these hours to put this event on, and maybe 100, 200 people attend the event. But more important than that is that thousands could attend by watching it on social media. But of course, you don't think about this until after the event is over. You can't afford not to capture it for social media. And despite what people think, I am affordable. Give me a call. Let's plan your next video project and share it with the world on my social media television network. I promise you that you will have the attention of one person, me.